Welcome. In today's podcast, I'm going to address a question which is asked very frequently. Almost after every session, I get this question. So, what is that question? Oh, why are there so many features in Office? So, let me answer this question. How do I go about doing that? Well, first, let me give you a brief answer. There are so many features because you need them. That's right. Most of us think, no, I don't need all these features. My job is getting done with whatever little I know. So what I know is enough, and what I don't know, how do I care? It must be useless. I am assuming it is useless. And that's the thought process. Now what I am saying is, unless proved otherwise, a feature is useful to you. Just think of it that way. Anyway, let's take a step back and think, why and how are features created? Remember, we are talking about software. In this case, about Office, but what I'm saying applies to any piece of software. When a feature is created, before that feature came into being, something was being done in an inefficient or lengthy way. And using this feature, that same thing is happening in a better way, improvement. Or that feature is giving me a completely new capability. Okay, so every feature starts somewhere. Does it start in the minds of some academician who is a genius? No. How Microsoft creates features? Yes, some features they start with, but then people use those features and say, no, this is not right. I want this and this not working properly. It's too slow. So a lot of feedback. Microsoft also keeps testing. They have focus groups. They observe how people are working. There is also automatic telemetry, which tells them how people use the features which are already there. And from all these sources, we have a lot of new feature requests. They are prioritized. The most commonly requested or needed things are implemented. Now, that's how all these features came about. Let me tell you an interesting thing. Totally, do you know how many features? In fact, in 2015, I actually counted them, and that time the total was around 12,000 something. Now it must be 14,000 plus. Do you know why? Because in earlier days, new features means new version used to come every 3 years. Now new features are added every week practically. Yes, that is the speed with which things are happening. So thousands and thousands of features. The sad part is, most people don't know about it and they just ignore all those features, which is really depressing for people who wrote it. So much effort has gone into making it, but there is no reciprocation from us users. So let's look at this table. Table has a layout, menu or ribbon, and there are 24 odd buttons you can see up front. Most people have never explored all of them. So let's do that now. Select, obvious, I want to select something. Row, column, table. Now there is a fourth one. Sometimes it's a long, big cell and I want to only select the cell. How do you do that? From this menu, but there's a better way. Actually, if you take your cursor, it becomes like this and one click selects an entire cell. I'm sure you did not know that, but now that you know it, you would love it and you will use it. That's called discovering your needs. Let's proceed. Next, we have view grid lines. Why do you need grid lines? Because sometimes we want a table, but we don't want others to know it's a table. We just want the table for layout purpose. For example, I have this resume. I want name, address, all that properly aligned, but I don't want to show it as a table. Then I remove the table grid or the borders. But then when I'm editing the table, I'm confused now, where is the row and column? That's the time when I see grid lines. Grid lines don't get printed. That's why we need them. Next, properties. Probably most scary part, because so many options, nobody goes there. There are some brilliant ones there. For example, sometimes the table is small and then so much space is wasted around it. So why not let the text go around it? Looks much more professional, isn't it? That's called around. Another common problem, which I'm sure you have got disgusted with before. Sometimes the row breaks across pages and then you're struggling to say, how do I correct it? Then I control enter, split table, enter, enter, enter. No, come here. and make sure all rows are selected, because you never know which row will break tomorrow. And do not allow rows to break. This is called if there is a feature, it's satisfying a need. You always had that need. You didn't know this feature because you ignored it. Anyway, so next, draw table and erase table are absolute lifesavers. You can actually create a table just by drawing like this. Oh yes, you can create columns wherever you like, and any kind of columns, and you can merge cells by just dragging. So complex tables can be created in seconds using draw and erase. Now tell me, you didn't need this. Maybe you don't need to create a complex table today, but when you do, you are going to be efficient. That's what I mean. Solution is there when the need arises. So this is an obvious one, but one important thing to understand. This insert and delete, when you are working with tables, you need all 8 of them in some random order. So going here or right clicking and choosing them is really inefficient. So what do? One time in life, just go there and right click and say add to quick access toolbar. Now, in one click, you can choose anyone you need. Fine. Now merge cells, split table, obvious, you already know how to use them. Auto fit is a lifesaver. Very often when we copy paste from Excel or web page, it goes outside the page. How do you get it in? Auto fit to window. Now sometimes the table distribution of column width is not proper, so you say auto fit to contents. And then if you have optimized the content width or column width properly and you don't want it to auto adjust, then you say fixed column width. Often we want the same row height for all rows and same column width for all columns. One click does it. These I have taken as one feature because they are just various types of alignment. Text direction, useful when you are creating a long table and you want to have something vertically. And cell margins are really useful. Very often when it's a crowded table, readability suffers when it's tightly packed. So just give some space above, below. Left, right space is already there. Above, below is important. Makes it easier to understand, looks more professional. This is something we use in Excel every day, but in Word, you can do all kinds of sorting, multi-level of sorting actually, using this feature. Many people don't know it. Repeat header rows. Yes, you have suffered because of this before. Long table goes on the next page, the header doesn't come, then you copy paste. Come on, click inside the header, one or more rows, by the way. Header, rows, repeat. That's it. And finally, sometimes we want table to be converted to text. So reverse of convert text to table is available here. And last but not the least, formulas. Amazing formulas can be added right within Word. I have a video for that. Have a look at it. So that is a quick walkthrough through one of those crowded feature sets. Now take a deep breath. Think about what you have been thinking about Office. And now tell me, are these features useless? Yeah, now you're slowly starting to realize that instead of ignoring these gems, I should be exploring them, because just by virtue of exploring them, I am discovering my own needs, which I have had for decades and I was asleep. And because I was not noticing these, I was getting this thing done in the worst possible way. Imagine how much time, energy, and precious life you have wasted because of this attitude. So what is the right attitude? Don't fall into the trap of basic and advanced. Watch this video to understand the correct mindset. In short, every button there is a solution. To what? That is what you have to discover. And the process of discovery is the efficient mindset, and it will transform your life for better. So there was a question, why are there so many features? Now you know the answer. Someone originated that feature, but only that someone is not going to benefit. Everyone at large is going to benefit, provided you are thinking about it in a positive, proactive manner. I hope this podcast helps you open your eyes and mind. And more importantly, it's not just an irritating question and I answered you. It actually will improve your life, because with the right mindset, you have no idea how much time you can save and how many new things you can do which are really useful, powerful, and can catalyze your growth. So that's it for this podcast, but make sure you see the rest. There are lots of thought-provoking and value-adding podcasts in this playlist. So till next time, take care. Bye-bye. And whenever you get bored, look at a feature, find the need behind it, and life is good. See you.